Roger McGough, you're a poet. What does being a poet mean to you?
I suppose it means that it's what I feel is more important. You know, that when I decided that I wanted to be a poet, this was the sort of my vocation. And this is the most important thing to me. I was doing other things. I mean, for a while I was a teacher. So being a teacher was my profession. And at the moment, of course, I work the scaffold and do theatre shows. So that is my profession. But whatever I did professionally, I'd always be basically a poet. So I found the most important too. When I'm on my own, that's what I tend to be doing is writing, I think.
Where do you get your ideas from?
Oh, from all around, you know, from newspapers, from walking around the streets, from the things that normally move you. Sometimes I just come here, for instance, and work in here, because it's quiet, and I sit down and off with a sheet of paper. I have no idea for a poem, but I'll sort of write a word down or a smudge or doodle for a bit, and then write a line and then create and then sort of write the poem outline.
When you look at your poetry on a printed page, some of it seems to be arranged in patterns of words. Why is that?
Well, it's like when you're faced with the blank page in the morning, and a lot of the poems I write, I read aloud. But initially, the whole thing is writing them down, you know, is the pleasure of writing them on the page. And I find that it's just like playing with the sort of the page itself. I'll use, don't you see here, but just by actually writing of it, not to write them all down in a line, but to space them out, join words together. It makes a sort of pattern, capital letters and this sort of thing. Sometimes just playing with writing the margin on the opposite side of the page, the right-hand side of the page. So when you read it, the breath works in a different sort of way, so you get a different sort of breathing pattern when you're reading it. You see, it's just that I like E. Cummings, a lot of E. Cummings stuff. We did this a lot, and James Joyce. A lot of writers really went into the words themselves as games and wordplay. I like this very much. And a lot of poets often lack this. They're very good intellectually and things, but they often, it's a love of words and like a game with words, which I enjoy. And that's what, you know, that's myself. I just like playing it out like that. So you open a book and you see, you get a surprise every page. You turn over and there's nice things in it.
What use is poetry today?
This is the thing where there's so much going on in the world, you know, so much like Belfast and Bangladesh and all that, you wonder what use is anything like this. I think on a personal level, like when I first read poetry, when I was younger, and I felt all sort of mixed feelings about things, and I was unsure of myself, then I read some poetry and I feel that I saw that somebody felt perhaps the same as I do, or could put in words the way I was feeling. And I felt a sort of great strength from this. And I suppose this is why I feel with the writing of poetry that I'm sort of crystallising things I see and feelings I have, and hope that perhaps some people can read it or listen to me reading and associate what I'm saying, and, you know, and make them feel sort of better. You know, it's a way of all that art is really. I mean, I don't know, I feel very, you know, I'd love to be able to be wise about it and say, you know, poetry is good for you and follow me and it'll do this, and it won't, you know, because I'm a very fail human being like anybody else, you know, and often feel sort of whatever you're trying to do is just a drop in the ocean, you know, and people also expect, because you're a poet as well, that what you say is going to be true, or that what I'm saying now has some significance, and it hasn't, you know, because when you've left this afternoon, I may totally disagree with what I've said just now, because people do, people change their minds, and also one of the reasons I write poetry is because I can't communicate very well on this level, in a way, in talking. I admire people who can just talk and get ideas and give out. And it's great. And I can't do this. I go away after the interview. I think, well, I should have said then, what I could have said then. Then I write it down. And for me, poetry is this. Poetry is like recollecting in retrospect sort of thing.
Roger, you're very much a Liverpudlian, born and bred in the city. How important is Liverpool to your work?
Well, initially, I felt it was very important because I'd come back from Hull, been away, in a sense, from Liverpool 4 years. And it was great to walk around and seeing the place names again, and this is very important. And then for a while I felt I was like an international playboy, you know, I wanted to be international, I wanted to extend the barriers of the poetry. And then just lately I found that really if I'm writing a poem about a person, about an old man or something, moving through the town, through a town, I tend to look for the right sounding name and the right sort of place. And always it seems to be in Liverpool, that whatever happens I'm to my own sort of where I was brought up in, and I feel probably happier for certain types of poetry in Liverpool, yeah. I suppose to some extent it is, you know, what I write is personal, I think it's personal. I'm not writing for other people to react to it. But I suppose, in a sense, that the fact that enough people react with it in the same sort of way means it's sort of getting it across in many ways. I think Liverpool people, the sort of Irish tradition and the rest of it, Celtic tradition, there's certain people are witty and things. I wouldn't like to pose as a poet, you know, don't go around saying I'm a poet, and I wouldn't like to be seen in public writing things down, because people think there's something wrong with you. Because in Liverpool, people are interested in other things, you know, there's more to life than just poetry. But I write it, and also I find that trying to be, using some comedy in the things helps as well. It helps to get across any sort of feeling you have. You know, I'd hate to be just posing and make it all sort of effete and soft. The poetry I sort of read now tends to be modern poetry, tends to be like most current English poetry and American poetry and the like. And I keep telling myself that I'll get down to reading the backbone of English poetry, you know, the Palgrave's Treasury of Golden Verse and all this stuff. Because I have a feeling, it's a sneaking suspicion, that the way poetry is introduced to many children, certainly when I was younger, is often the wrong way. I was brought up on Shakespeare, and I think Shakespeare should have an X certificate in schools, as far as schools goes, in some ways.
You mean that it shouldn't be taught in schools?
Well, very carefully. I think a lot of English teachers take an easy way out by using Shakespeare because he's there, and a lot of the good English poets. It seems a pity because often children can't, I feel, relate to it. It's nothing, it's outside their experience. It isn't interesting to them.
You've talked about walking around the streets of Liverpool and seeing things happen. Is it your own sense of poetry that makes these things seem bigger than they are? Or are they there for everyone to see?
They're there for everybody to see. Well, certainly I think everybody sees things. And I won't even say that I feel them more than anybody else. I wouldn't be as egotistical. Everybody sees things and people often move to the same degree. But what I do is I will often write about them. I just say, go home and embroider on them. At the same time, I won't say that all the time I'm going around writing with a book in my hand and writing and looking around for things. I'm not. Most of the time I'm doing whatever else is doing. Looking at shop windows, looking at girls and wondering about what's on the pictures and other things. You know, I'm not always being the poet. You know, giving this impression. It isn't true. But just that sometimes I'm aware of it all the time, deep down, whatever I'm thinking about. That's my, vocation, is being a poet, you know, it's what I'm best at.